Let's move on now to this other story, which again raises the alarm of the safety of students in hostels in particular. And of course, the issue of mental well-being is something that has come to the fore once again. We have a story here of 14 people, of which 11 are students and 3 employees, arrested for abetment to suicide of a 12th standard student who was found hanging in his hostel room on the 18th of January. The teenager allegedly committed suicide because of harassment after being sodomized by the arrested students and staffers for 1 year. The accused have been charged with abetment to suicide, sodomy and relevant sections of the POXO Act. While 8 juveniles have been sent to remand home, the others are in police custody.
मृत्यूच्या अगोदर त्याच्या काही भावना आहेत किंवा जे काही त्याचं म्हणणं आहे ते एका वहीमध्ये लिहून ठेवलं होतं. ती वही तपासांतर्गत प्राप्त झाली आणि त्याच्यानुसार याच्यामध्ये 14 व्यक्तीविरुद्ध गुन्हा दाखल करण्यात आलेला आहे आणि पुढील तपास सुरू आहे. त्यामध्ये 19 विद्यार्थी आहेत आणि 3 कर्मचारी त्या सेवाग्रामाचे आहेत.
My colleague Mayuresh Ganpatye is joining me now with more inputs on the story. Mayuresh, as we were going through the details of this story, it looked more and more horrifying to me. The fact that so many people were involved in sodomizing a teenager, it seems as if these things are happening, these things are rampant, and it only comes out when something of this nature happens, when the child commits suicide. Until now, for a year this went on, nobody raised the alarm, nobody reported this kind of thing. Isn't that extremely dangerous? Tell us, in this particular case, what are the details that we have now after the suicide was committed? What are the details shared by the police on this?
Yes, this 12th standard student basically committed a suicide on 18th of Jan, and while doing the investigation of his suicide, police came to know came across a diary basically which he used to maintain, and in that diary he had written explicitly in length he has written about the sexual harassment which he was facing in the entire year, and regularly he was facing such sexual harassment, not only from the colleagues with whom he was staying in the hostel, but also from the people who were kind of responsible to manage that hostel. But in such scenario, police had, on the basis of that diary, basically police had booked 14 people, 3 are the staffers and other 11 are the students, out of which we have been given to understand 7 are juvenile.
Right. Right, Mayuresh, thanks for giving us that update. I want to bring in Sanjana now because she has more details on the probe now and the status of the probe, what the investigations have revealed. Sanjana, good morning. If you can take us through the information that we have with regards to the probe and the revelations that has been made.
Afrida, first let's take you through the details of the probe. Now, what the police actually discovered is, you know, they were not really sure about what exactly happened because this boy was found hanging from this iron beam in the hostel room, but the police were unsure because he shared the room with 5 other people. So the words "Yunak" were actually scribbled, they were scrawled on the hostel wall, and that's when the police actually figured that perhaps this was a case of sexual harassment, that perhaps this was a case of mental harassment and torture, where this boy was actually a victim of bullying. After that, what happened was the police were able to then recover a notebook where this boy actually listed the kind of torture, the kind of ordeal that he had to face, and that's when the police were able to nab the accused. As Mayuresh rightly said, that most of them, surprisingly, were juveniles, most of them were his friends, and some of them, surprisingly also, were hostel staffers, Afrida.
Right, so that leads me to my next question, Sanjana. Since you broached it, let's also give our viewers an idea of what was recovered. One of the things recovered is the victim's notebook. I believe there are some startling disclosures there. If you can take us through some of the excerpts, please.
Afrida, perhaps the most glaring part about this entire case is the kind of ordeal that this boy had to go through and the fact that he had to go through this for over a year. Now, let's remember, this boy actually hailed from a village in the district. He was staying in the hostel for the last 7 years and he made note of all of this in a notebook. So, in the first one, he said that he was actually sexually harassed. Let me take you through those details. He said that he was sexually harassed and mentally harassed by his hostel mate and staffers for over a year. After that, he said that even junior students violated him. Let's remember, Afrida, that at least 7 to 8 of these people who have been arrested are juveniles. So he lists about how even juveniles and even junior hostel mates harassed him. He also talks about how this harassment, this mental torture, went on for over a year. You know, it just gets ghastlier from there, Afrida, where he spoke about how he had to even deal with this, how he was forced into unnatural sex even on his birthday. Afrida, chillingly and very dishearteningly, his birthday was just 2 days before he ended his life, where he was found hanging from this iron beam in his hostel room on January the 18th.
Right. Thanks so much, Sanjana, for taking us through those important details. And we have access to all this information from the police, from our reporters on the ground, trying to build the story, the horror of it all, for our viewers. Now, the thing is that here is a case of a teenager found hanging in his room after a prolonged period of harassment, mental and physical, that he went through. He had absolutely nobody to turn to, from what we can understand, because all the 3 people who were responsible for monitoring the hostel seemed to be complicit in the crime. There were as many as 7 of his peers who also was complicit in it. So one can imagine he had nobody to turn to. His peers were against him. They were involved in it, and so were his superiors, his guardians, rather, in the hostel. We'll have to leave it at that and shift focus now.